Hello all, today we'll start with the applications of trigonometry. In that, first we'll deal with heights and distances. I'll tell you the concepts of angle of elevation, angle of depression, line of sight. So then we'll go to the problems. So consider a building and a person is standing here. So this will be the horizontal line. Now, a person looks at the top of the building. First, I'll tell you what is the horizontal line. It is nothing but the distance from the building to the person. Now, this person is trying to watch the top of the building, this point. We'll go to the concept of line of sight. The line of sight is nothing but the line drawn from the eye of the person to the point in the object viewed by the observer. Now this is the object, the building, here is the object. So the point in the object is this point. So line drawn from the eye of the observer, that is from here to here. So this will be the line of sight. This will be the line of sight. Next, we'll go to the angle of elevation. So I'll do one thing. I'll draw this. Now, distance from his eyes to the building, the horizontal distance is the same as this horizontal line. So I'll tell you what is angle of elevation. This is the line of sight. This is the horizontal line. Now, angle of elevation is the angle made by this line of sight with this horizontal line. Let it be theta. I am taking it as theta. The angle made by this line of sight with the horizontal line, if the point viewed is above this horizontal line. So, I am repeating it. What is angle of elevation? Angle of elevation. The angle of elevation is nothing but the angle made by this line of sight with this horizontal line. This is parallel to this line. So I took this line. The angle made by the line of sight with the horizontal line when the object being viewed or the point being viewed. The object being viewed is this. And we are viewing this. So, if it is above the horizontal line, then the angle made by this line of sight with this horizontal line is called angle of elevation. So, this theta will be the angle of elevation. Next, we'll go to angle of depression. So, now angle of depression, a boy is standing on the top of a building and his school bag is on the ground. He tries to watch the school bag from the top of the building. Here, the line of sight will be the line drawn from the eye of the person to the point in the object viewed by the observer. This is the point that is being watched by this observer or the boy. So, this will be line of sight. What is angle of depression? Before going to angle of depression, here the horizontal line will be this. You might be wondering, the horizontal line here is down and this is up. This distance is same as this distance. But why? Because previously in this case, the boy is looking up with respect to the ground, with respect to the horizontal line. In this case, the boy is looking down with respect to this horizontal line. Okay, so that is why this horizontal line is top. Now, what is angle of depression? The angle of depression is nothing but the angle made by the line of the sight with this horizontal line, let it be alpha, and this will be the angle of depression. So the angle made by the line of the sight with the horizontal line, okay, when the object being viewed, this is the object being viewed, is below the horizontal line, because he is viewing it downwards. The horizontal line is this top, not on the ground. This is the horizontal line in this case. So the object being viewed is this, and it is below the horizontal line, or simply, since he is looking downwards, it will be angle of depression. That's it. Now, what is the application? Suppose you want to calculate the height of a mountain, or height at which aeroplane is flying, or anything. Or do you think, how did they calculate the height of Everest or big mountains? The application of trigonometry is very important in those cases. There is an instrument called theodolite. It is a surveying instrument which has a telescopic sight, which is used for measuring horizontal and vertical angles. I'm marking these points. I'll mark this as P, Q, R, S. Let this point be A, and this point be B, this point be C. So, PR is the height of the person. So, this PR, this height, will be obviously equal to BC, because I have drawn a line parallel to this. Okay? So, I know RS, which is equal to PQ. Okay? The same RS will be equal to PQ. So, height of this building is AC, which is equal to AB plus BC. Now, this BC is equal to the height of this person, PR. So, we don't know what is AB. We'll find AB. As I mentioned earlier, there are instruments called theodolites, which get the angle of elevation. Suppose a person is viewing the top of this building with that instrument, it will get the angle of elevation. So, let this angle be theta. So, the angle of elevation is theta. So, I need to get the height of the building. Now, I'll mark the most important point, that is O. This is the point at which the object is located. So, I want AB. Can you say this AB is equal to OQ? Yes. AB is equal to OQ. Yes, it is. So, what will I do? I'll try to get OQ. So, consider this triangle POQ. This is 90 degree. POQ. This is 90 degrees. I'm again once again saying, consider this triangle POQ. Okay. So, this AB is equal to OQ. We know this theta. We know the value of PQ. Okay. What is PQ value? It is nothing but, it is RS. So, I'll write tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side by adjacent side. So, opposite side is OQ. and adjacent side is PQ. So OQ is PQ tan theta. But what is PQ? PQ is nothing but RS. So OQ is RS tan theta. So I got this OQ. Okay, now I know QS. So height of the building is, what is the height of the building? OQ plus QS. It is nothing but AB plus BC. OQ is AB. So I'll write AB is equal to RS tan theta. I can say height of the building AB plus BC. I know the value of AB. AB is RS tan theta. BC plus RS tan theta is equal to AC. So this is the height of the building AC. So I got AB, which is equal to RS tan theta. This RS is nothing but the horizontal distance from the building to the person. And what is BC? BC is nothing but the height of the person. Okay. So we got AC, we got the height of the building. In this way, we can calculate the heights of different buildings. Thank you.
If you like the video, please hit the like button, comment, and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe for all our future videos.